Hi guys, welcome back to Kids Corner.
We are excited to have another lesson this week. Have you all ever seen these before? What are they? They're binoculars, right? They help you see things more closely that are really far away. So these binoculars will help you see things more closely and clearly that are far away. Like maybe at a baseball game, when you're trying to see the players on the field and you're sitting way up in the stands, you could use some binoculars.
Call a strike!
Or maybe you would use binoculars if you're out in the woods to see deer or birds.
Shh, I think I see a deer.
I'm not a deer, I'm Bella.
Just like we can use binoculars to see things more closely, we should look into God's Word more closely so that we can see what He's trying to teach us. We'll talk about that more here in a little bit.
But first, join Sydney and Bella as they sing a song with us.
Join us as we sing deep and wide.
Don't forget to do the motions with us.
Deep and wide, deep and wide, there's a fountain flowing deep and wide.
Bum, 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 bum.
Deep and wide, deep and wide, there's a fountain flowing deep and wide. Wide and deep, wide and deep, there's a fountain flowing wide and deep.
Bum, 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 bum,
wide and deep. Wide and deep, there's a fountain flowing wide and deep.
Now we're gonna sing, read your Bible. Neglect your Bible, forget to pray. Forget to pray, forget to pray. Neglect your Bible, forget to pray. And you'll shrink, shrink, shrink. And you'll shrink, shrink, shrink. And you'll shrink, shrink, shrink. Neglect your Bible, forget to pray, and you'll shrink, shrink, shrink. But read your Bible, pray every day, pray every day, pray every day. Read your Bible, pray every day, and you'll grow, grow, grow. And you'll grow, grow, grow. And you'll grow, grow, grow. Read your Bible, pray every day, and you'll grow, grow, grow.
All right, so one of our favorite things to do, and I'm sure one of your favorite things to do, is eat. So we want to see if you can guess some of our favorite foods.
I'm thinking of one. Let's see if you guys can guess it. The one I'm thinking of is something that I like to do because I like to cook out on the grill. And this item, this food, I cook out on the grill. And this food, you put on a bun, you put cheese on it, and ketchup and mustard, and sometimes mayonnaise and lettuce. And if you're weird, you might even put tomatoes and onions and pickles on there. I would not do that myself, but sometimes people would do that. Can you guys guess what I'm thinking of? That's right, a cheeseburger.
Well,
that one's a little plasticky though.
That does sound good, but I wonder if you can guess what my favorite snack is. It's a fruit, and it's round. And my favorite are green, but you can also get them red too. Do you know what it is? It's an apple.
I also, is that good?
That's good.
I also like fruit. And one of my favorite fruits is also green, but it's a lot bigger than an apple. On the inside, it's red and it has black seeds. And it's very watery and it's very melony. So it's a watermelon.
That was a good clue.
Thank you.
All right, my last one is a favorite treat. We don't have it a whole lot. Maybe at your birthday. It's fluffy on the inside. It's got icing on the outside. Can you guess what it is?
Don't throw it.
How about some cake? I can't eat this one though.
No. I also like desserts quite a bit. And one of my favorite desserts you eat in the morning. And the dessert that I'm talking about, sometimes it can be filled with jelly, sometimes it can be filled with cream, sometimes it has a hole in the middle. That's right, it's a donut.
All right, well, that was fun. But you know, food has a lot in common with God's word. And in God's word, in 1 Timothy, he talks about how we should desire his word like newborn babies need food and desire food to grow. We need to use God's word to grow closer to him and to grow in our spiritual walk.
Join us as we sing the B-I-B-L-E. The B-I-B-L-E, yes, that's the book for me. I stand alone on the word of God, the B-I-B-L-E, Bible!
Okay, so earlier we talked about how binoculars help us see things more closely and how we need to look at God's word more closely. And then we talked about food for a little bit and our favorite different kinds of food. And right now we're going to spend the next few minutes talking about how God's word is like food for us. And the first thing we're going to talk about today is that we need, God's word is like food, and then we need it often. You wouldn't be able to survive if you only ate once a month, even if you only ate once a week. If you're like my 14-year-old son, you might not be able to survive if you ate once every 10 minutes. We need, just like we need food often, we need God's word often. We're not going to be able to grow spiritually if we only read God's word once a year, or once a month, or even once a week. We need to be reading God's word daily.
Another way that God's word is like food is it's satisfying. So think about having your favorite food after your stomach and your body has been craving it all day long. Well, God's word can be that for our souls too, because we can read God's word and feel good about knowing that we're doing what God wants us to do. It can satisfy us. It can help us grow closer to God.
Another thing is that God's word helps us grow. Just like food helps us grow physically, God's word helps us grow spiritually. The Bible talks about the fact that when we're babies, we drink milk and that helps us grow. And then we get to a certain point where we're eating solid foods and we're eating meat. And that helps us grow even more and grow bigger and stronger. And the Bible compares that to reading God's word. When we're young Christians, we need to be reading God's word. And we may not understand the big parts of God's word, like just like a baby can't handle eating meat whenever it's a baby. But we need to read God's word anyway. And we'll understand some of the more easy to understand things. And then later on, as we grow as Christians, we'll understand some of the things that are a little more difficult to understand. But the only way that we're going to do that is if we actually read God's word. And if we do that, we'll grow spiritually. So we've learned a lot this week. We learned that we need to look closely into God's word and that God's word is like spiritual food for us.
We hope you've had a lot of fun with us this week on Kids Corner. Now be sure to tune in to the Facebook Live service with Brother Steve coming up in just a minute. And we'll see you back next week for Kids Corner.